When it rains, it pours. That was the lesson of 2018, a year that started with a flash crash and finished with an equity sell-off in the autumn. Nearly 90% of all asset classes globally recorded a negative return in dollars. We did expect poor returns because of a deteriorating growth inflation mix and rich asset valuation. It only got worse than we expected. 2019 also looks tough, but for different reasons. Equity valuation is less stretched, but global growth will continue to slow. The US economy has been firing on all cylinders, but the impact of the fiscal stimulus will soon start to fade. The question is not whether the US economy will slow, but by how much. In contrast, there is too much pessimism about the euro area and China right now. So expect the 2018 divergence to reverse partly in 2019. There is a first investment theme here. The US dollar will run out of steam, and this should provide selective relief to emerging markets assets. On the policy front, the tide of easy monetary policy had lifted all assets. As this tide goes out, asset performance suffers. Luckily, the Fed will blink in 2019, and the pause in the rate hike cycle will offer moderate relief. The ECB will proceed very cautiously with the exit strategy. We see a hike only at the very end of the year. China and Europe will also be providing moderate fiscal support. In all, the receding policy tide is slow, but late cycle fears will not disappear. By mid-2019, we'll be celebrating the 10-year anniversary of the US growth cycle, the longest ever. This creates an unpleasant asymmetry for risk assets. Limited upside, larger downside. There is also the politics. The trade war is here to stay, but President Trump will be looking forward to the 2020 election and cannot afford a full-blown trade war. Our core scenario also includes a soft Brexit and some de-escalation between Italy and the EU. However, we expect nervous trading into the European election in May. And there are wild cards, such as tariffs on autos, a major risk for Germany. So, tail risks are fat, and smart hedging remains of the essence. We see no value in 10-year bonds at 0.25% and prefer cash. 10-year German real yields are still around -1% and exposed to normalization as the ECB ends QE. We see value in inflation, given the cheap pricing of breakevens. The trade war and more generally populism should support inflation. We see the sell-off in credit as overdone for now. Expect some near-term relief, but mind the asymmetry. If and when the economy turns, spreads can go a lot wider, especially in the US. Euro corporate bonds now look too cheap relative to the US. Likewise, in equities, the current sell-off is overdone, following a huge shift in economic sentiment, especially in Europe. Valuation is now more attractive, but earnings consensus forecast remain too high. Expect positive but meager equity returns over the coming year. Prefer value over growth and Europe over the US. Let me conclude here and wish you a happy holiday season and, of course, successful investment in 2019.